will mark the halfway point of their season this Sunday in Minnesota. And as we look at their upcoming schedule brought to you by Ticketmaster, we see the second half of the season will be anything but easy. Half of their last eight games will be against teams from the NFC North. The Cardinals and Bills are the only teams on the Lions' remaining schedule currently with records below 500. Things are much better here on Lions Game Plan now that I've made it to the food court at 12 Oaks Mall in Novi. Sure, shopping is fun, but no trip is complete without getting something to eat. The Vikings might be looking for a feast of their own on Sunday, but Matt Patricia and his defense will try to make sure that doesn't happen. The head coach is back with Matt Shepard one last time to break down the Vikings' attack.
Tori, thanks. The Vikings rely heavily on their aerial assault. Kirk Cousins is number one in the league in completions, number two in the league in yards, number three in attempts, and number four in completion percentage. Is he better in Minnesota than he was in Washington? And if so, how?
I mean, I think they're just doing a great job with the system up there. I think he's really, he understands kind of where to get the ball and how to get it to his go-to players. I think he's doing a great job of reading the defenses and putting the team in a great situation to have successful plays. They do a really good job kind of, as the statistics say, staying on track and just keeping that offense moving. And then when they have those opportunities, they'll get the ball downfield, and they're pretty quick strike when they do.
Yeah, a lot like your offense where you got some guys who can go get it, need some speed, need some length, need some concentration. He's got it in Stephon Diggs.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, he does a great job here kind of, you know, using the motion to identify what the defense is in. Little play action here. They've run the ball extremely well. They use the play action to get the ball vertical, reads the safety kind of diving down as the over routes come to him. And then he just, you know, sees Diggs running right through the middle of the field, knows that he's going to be able to get by the middle of the field safety, and then just puts the ball out there. He's got a really strong arm. Quarterback understands where the coverage players are going to be. And then obviously his connection with Diggs here has come on real fast.
What's his read there? Is it the safety high, 29? Is that his read?
Yeah, you know, what he sees really on this one is you can see 21 kind of dive down on the over route right there. He knows the middle of the field safety is going to be stressed. He has two verticals going by him in this situation. Middle field safety, he moves him with his eyes. You can see right here from this shot, he does a good job of kind of moving the middle of the field safety to the other over route, which opens up the middle of the field here for Diggs screaming through. So he really focuses on the middle field safety, moves him at the last minute. You can see his eyes transfer back over to Diggs, which then he puts the ball out there with his speed, his ability to track the ball, his ball skills. It's just points right away.
Love the ability to just move people with your eyes. There are so many keys in football that sometimes we just don't see. Diggs, by the way, 58 catches, fourth most in the NFC. Nobody has more catches, nobody has more yards than Adam Thielen. What makes him special? Because not many people know enough about this guy.
Yeah, I mean, this guy is a really good wide receiver. This guy is a dynamic route runner. And I think, he just does a great job of understanding leverage and getting open. Another couple examples of them using their play action ability to, get the linebackers or the secondary to kind of squeeze up a little bit, open up the intermediate range. And with his ability to kind of get in and out of cuts, good timing by the quarterback, it's almost unstoppable.
Kind of like a security blanket to a certain extent.
I mean, there's no doubt the quarterback's looking for him in all these situations. They got a little bit of a, motion here with the fullback, bring him out, bring him back in, kind of give a little bit of a coverage identification for the quarterback. As he takes the snap, he knows he's going to have the play action here, gets up right away, sees the linebacker and the safeties kind of, get brought up into the line of scrimmage, which creates that intermediate space. You can see Thielen up at the top. He kind of works the corner out, stems him out, gets him to open his hips, crosses him back to the inside, and then he closes his hips in. And his ability to get in and out of this break, come in, snap back outside, that's a really hard route to defend right there, and it's a pretty easy pitch and catch for the quarterback.
Coach is always looking at little things, the hips. 22 catches on third down for Adam Thielen, 49 on first down catches, most in the NFL. Tori, again, you're out there shopping, I know that. I do notice you always have food for some reason during the show, and we don't get any. Why is that?
Yeah, the producers know the best way to keep me at the top of my game on the show is to make sure I am fed. Here's hoping the Lions are at the top of their game on Sunday against the Vikings. That's all the time we have for this edition of Lions Game Plan. I'm Tori Petri. Thanks so much for watching and enjoy the game. Actually, I think I've got time to go buy those shoes I wanted.